welcome back to the channel, or welcome if you are brand new to the channel. Thank you for watching. My name is Okwari. I am the main face of this channel, or who you're gonna see on this channel, although I do have a few supporters behind the scenes. If you are interested in seeing our animal loving journey, be sure to subscribe, turn on the notification bell, and like each of our videos so that way we can be able to be monetized and start building our animal rescue center here in the near future. So please do those three things if you are interested in seeing that. While we do not have our animal rescue center open at the time being, be sure to check the links in the description and the about page of our YouTube channel, where we provide animal related organizations for you to donate to on your free time. Before I start the video, yes, I did have my hair dyed and it's a little bit different, so today we're going to be covering what is the slowest animal in the world. And we're not covering mammals, we're covering animal. On the channel, I already did cover what's the fastest animal in the world, so if you're interested in seeing that, go ahead and go on our YouTube channel and see where that is. It was a few weeks ago. So most of the time when people think of the slowest animal in the world, they're gonna think of the three-toed sloth. Well, that's actually not the case. The slowest animal in the world, as of right now, is the sea anemone, otherwise known as the flower of the sea. It goes 0.0001 kilometers per hour, which, in other words, is 10 centimeters per hour, which isn't even a foot length per hour. So why do they travel so slowly? Well, the truth is, sea anemones don't actually need to move. They just stay where they are and wait for their prey in order to eat. However, when they do need to move for any sort of reason, they move with their petal disc. I do have a few videos at the end of this video to show you of how sea anemones actually move in the water. So stick around for that if you are interested in seeing a few clips of that. So the petal disc is actually their base, it's underneath them, and that is how they are moving in any sort of way. This petal disc sticks to any surface under the water. Basically, how they move is just gliding with that petal disc. And the only reason that they would move would be that they feel threatened in any sort of way. However, there are different types of sea anemones, and you'll see that in the videos at the end of this video. So their main predator is the sea slug, which doesn't really have a warning when they're interested in feasting on the sea anemone. And as soon as they are touched or they realize that they are being preyed upon, they start to move. Some sea anemones help the petal disc, which is their base, by flapping their tentacles. This movement is similar to jellyfish. Some sea anemones can just wiggle off the base surface that they are on. Like I said, there are different types of sea anemones, so it does depend on where they're at and what type of sea anemone that they are, and their petal disc, and their form. So let me show you a few videos of how they move, and one video I believe is the sea anemone getting, or about to be getting attacked, and how they move according to that. So that's all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to subscribe, turn on the notification bell, and like our videos so that way we can open our animal rescue center here in the near future. Be sure to look in the description down below for the links I did for this video, my research. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.